everyone. Welcome into the Coach Chris Oliver Show. I'm Chris Wells. Coach will join me in just a few moments. This week, we'll take a look back at the Blue Raiders 10-0 loss at Presbyterian last Thursday night. We will also preview this Saturday's homecoming game as Lindsey Wilson hosts Cincinnati Christian at Blue Raiders Stadium. A little bit of a different start time at 2:30 p.m. Central Time instead of the normal 1:30. So once again, 2:30 p.m. kickoff for Lindsey Wilson and Cincinnati Christian. We'll also have our student athlete spotlight as Lindsey Wilson tight end Scotty Krantz joins me later on in this show. When we come back, Coach will join me. This is the Coach Chris Oliver Show on the Lindsey Wilson Sports Network. Back to the Coach Chris Oliver Show. Coach joins me now, and Coach, obviously wasn't the best performance of Lindsey Wilson football, but you go down, you go on the road, it's a 10-point game, had a chance to win it even till the very end. I got to think there's some positives that you can take out of this.
Yeah, for sure. I mean, time will tell on what we take out of it. The opportunity to learn is certainly very large. You know, we knew it was going to be a challenge when we went down there, and anytime you say, hey, let's play truly up, you know, a level, you know, and go play a Division I team and those things, you know that, you know, you're taking on a challenge that is unusual. But that's a game that was winnable for us. And we felt like it was as we prepared. I felt like being at the game and now grading the video and stepping away from the game for a few days, that's a game that we could have won. And I think that's a testament to how far we've come, but, you know, coulda, shoulda, didn't. And, you know, we didn't play as well as we could have. Now, there were some bright spots. There were certainly some good moments. I felt like, for the most part, our defense played very well. Obviously, there's a couple opportunities there we'd like to have back on defense. But our defense played very well for the most part. On special teams, we made a few good positive plays with our opportunities. We had a really good kickoff return. Our kickoff for the night was outstanding, the coverage on that. We punted the ball pretty well. You know, offensively, it was a struggle. You know, we just didn't execute consistently. There were some moments of a few big plays here and there. Just felt like we couldn't hit the one that was big enough and hurt ourselves with some penalties and, you know, just some things there that, you know, turnover in the red zone. Mm-hmm. So just a lot of, you know, tough situations and things that we didn't execute very well. So, you know, you're going to have that. And, you know, we've been through four games with this team. We haven't been challenged in a big way until this game. You know, just the first three games separated, you know, in the score, and we kind of ran away with them in different ways as the game went on. You know, we're going to have other close games as this season progresses. We're going to have some tough games, some tough situations, and we know that whenever we get an opportunity to be in the playoffs in the postseason, whether that's this season or whenever that next opportunity comes, those games are all going to be tough. Those games are all going to be close. You're going to have emotional moments. So, you know, this is an opportunity for us to go down there, play a very tough opponent. It didn't go our way. We're not pleased about that. We're not going to excuse the loss just because we played a bigger team. It's a team we felt like we had an opportunity to beat if we'd played better. But time will tell how much we take away from this. This has a great opportunity for us to learn, and now we've got to go back and continue to focus on how we execute, continue to focus on all the things that we get control over.
It's been a while since we've had a regular season loss, 3 years actually. And for the guys that have been here, are they upset about that? Obviously they're upset about it, but yeah. How are they handling it?
Well, so far I've been impressed with, you know, our mindset and how we're going to go about our business. You know, what I'm not hearing is, oh, we shouldn't have taken that game. We shouldn't have gone and taken that opportunity because now we ruin a perfect record and all that. If that's going on, I haven't heard it. You know, I think our guys were excited about the challenge. And I think at the end of the day, and this, you know, is no slight to Presbyterian. I mean, our guys know that that's a game that we could have won if we had played better and if we had executed our end of things better. So I think when you know that, when you know that that's a game, no matter what level they're on and on the road and short notice and all that stuff, when you know that, man, if we had executed better, we could have won that game, I think that takes away some of that other thought of, we shouldn't have taken that game. I don't think that's there for us. I think our guys were excited about the challenge. I don't think any of us wanted to play 9 games. I know none of us wanted to have 2 straight weekends off. And sometimes you got to take that challenge, and it didn't go our way. But this can still be a positive for us.
You said after watching the film, and you guys break down film unbelievably well, after watching the film, and I know you were disappointed right after the game. And did I hear you say that that you're a little bit more upbeat after watching the film than you were right after the game?
Well, I felt like maybe more frustrated might be the way. I mean, because I feel like the film confirmed the opportunities that we had. Now, they're a strong team. They executed very well Thursday night. You know, I thought they came in with a great game plan. They were coming off a short week, and they have a big conference game this week, and they clearly wanted to shorten the game. They ran the play clock down on offense, kept the ball out of our offense's hands, coming off a game when we scored 69 points. I mean, I thought their game plan was very strong, and I thought they executed very well. They're a well-coached team. But I felt like watching the video confirmed the opportunity that we had. So in some ways, that makes you feel like, well, we were right, you know, but in other ways, the bottom line is we didn't execute the way that we wanted to. So it's a little bit of both.
Lindsey Wilson falls at Presbyterian, their first loss of the season, 10-0 down in Clinton, South Carolina. We'll step away for a moment. We'll come back with Coach Oliver. This is the Coach Chris Oliver Show on the Lindsey Wilson Sports Network. Welcome back to the Coach Chris Oliver Show. Coach, I've got to think that going into every game, you probably have a mindset or a vision of how you think the game is going to play out. Mm-hmm. There may be two sets of visions, one how you hope it plays out, one how you really think it's going to play out. Did this game play out? Take away the score for a moment, yeah. But I guess there was only 8 drives apiece in the game.
Yeah.
Like you mentioned in the last segment, they really had ball control. Did it kind of play out the way that you thought it would?
Well, you know, we didn't think it was going to be a shootout, but it was certainly lower scoring than we had anticipated, especially on our side. I mean, you know, we should have had more success on offense. We never should have been shut out, you know. And again, their defense was strong. I mean, their defense was good, and that's a challenge. But, you know, there were so many things that we did not do well, that we have control over. And you know, so that didn't play out the way I thought. You know, this was a tough one to put your thumb on because even though we had a somewhat common opponent in Bluefield, we hadn't played Bluefield, but we've seen them. You know, that game separated in a big way. The entire schedule for the week was off, you know, for just preparation for both teams. And, you know, we're practicing on Sunday and going through those things. And then you have a lightning delay during the game, and you're playing on a grass field for the first time. And those things can't be excuses for us. You know, those things, that's just the nature of how sports go. That's the nature of how athletics go, and you take a challenge. You know, if we allow ourselves to say, well, you know, this was different, so you know, that can justify us not playing well. And, you know, that's not the mindset for us. It's a good opportunity for us to learn from those different situations. But I think all those things contributed to maybe having a difficult time to just put your thumb on how we expected the game to go. But it certainly was lower scoring than I think what I anticipated.
There was obviously some good moments during the game, but we talked in the pregame that in a game that matches two teams that are pretty close, and I got to think that you still believe that this, obviously the score indicated that a lot of times the battle in the trenches is something that you can look at and say, okay, that could be a difference in the game.
Yeah.
I thought, and I'd love to hear your thought, that at times we lost that battle rather significantly.
Well, we gave up some size on both sides of the ball. And, you know, anytime you go and play a Division I team, you would anticipate that some of their players may be a little bit larger than ours. And you know, I think that was the case, mm-hmm. Thursday night. I think they were a little bit bigger than us. I thought our defensive line really battled well. Mm-hmm. It was kind of a bend but don't break type of game for us. And even though they ran the ball pretty well and had some moments, we didn't give up a lot of the big runs. And, you know, we got off the field for the most part really well on third down. There were a couple, you know, two big third down conversions on their touchdown drive. And I think those might have been their only couple of the night on third down.
That's right.
So, you know, I thought our defensive line, we gave up a little bit of size, but I thought we really battled and settled in. But it was a tough road to hoe. Our offensive line, you know, we didn't execute very well. We're not going to sugarcoat it. We didn't play well. Our guys would tell you that as well. And, yes, their defensive line was good. And it was, we got into late in the fourth quarter, and it was clear that we had to throw the ball to try and make something happen. You know, we allowed them to pin their ears back, and they got after us pretty good. But, you know, their defensive line was good, and we gave up some size. But, you know, it kind of goes back to the same thing of we could have combated that in a better way if we would have executed better and had better technique and a number of things that, you know, the bottom line is, we got to have our guys more prepared and more ready to play as coaches, all of us, and that starts with me. And you know, we got to get back to the drawing board and continue to focus on how we execute.
The other thing that we talked about in the pregame and was the difference in the 12-day layoff versus the 5-day layoff. Who would have the advantage? And I'm not sure that anyone had an advantage, but I certainly thought that our offense was maybe limited, not limited, but struggled a bit because of the layoff. I didn't think we looked as crisp. It was almost as if the first game of the season after being off that long.
Yeah, there's a little bit of that, and then you negate that with, hey, we should be fresher than our opponent. So, you know, it goes both ways. And you know, yeah, there's that rhythm part of it. That you won, you come off a game where you play outstanding offensively the week before, and then you have the long break, and you know, all those things go into it, and it goes both ways. And you know, the bottom line is, you know, it comes down to executing one play at a time, 4 to 6 seconds at a time. And you know, we're not gonna use a long layoff as a crutch for us. You know, we didn't play well. If we had gone out and scored 30 some points against that defense, we might be sitting here saying, well, you know, that layoff was great because it gave us a chance to get fresh. So it goes both ways. And I don't disagree with you that may, you know, have played a part. But the bottom line is you execute one play at a time for 4 to 6 seconds at a time. When you do those things, then you allow yourself to build some momentum within a game. And we didn't do that very well.
Lindsey Wilson falls 10-0 at Presbyterian to fall to 3-1 on the season. Up next is homecoming weekend as Lindsey Wilson hosts Cincinnati Christian. We'll talk about them later on in this show. We're going to step away for 1 minute. We'll come back with our student-athlete spotlight. This is the Coach Chris Oliver Show on the Lindsey Wilson Sports Network. Welcome back to the Coach Chris Oliver Show. It's Student Athlete Spotlight time, and Scotty Krantz, tight end here on the Lindsey Wilson football team, joins me, coming from Christian Academy of Louisville, Cal. Tell me a little bit about how you came to Lindsey Wilson.
Well, I first heard about Lindsey Wilson my junior year. Coach Foos was recruiting me. He was first recruiting me actually for center. On offense. Then my senior year changed. She was recruiting me to play defensive end and linebacker. I wasn't that heavily recruited coming out of high school. I visited a couple other schools, the school up the road, Georgetown. But what was different about the visit here is I felt like the coaches truly cared about us and they wanted us to get a good education. And I could just feel the sincerity. So I think I'm glad I made this decision.
So you mentioned you played some offensive line in high school, some linebacker also. Tell me the whole story behind how you transitioned to being Lindsey Wilson's tight end.
Well, in high school, I mean, it was a very small team. We had about 35 guys. I was one of the bigger guys on the team. I played fullback earlier, my freshman and sophomore year. But they needed me to step up and play offensive line, and I was fine with it. And I was getting looks playing center, so I just kind of went with it. And then it transitioned to defense. Came here to play outside linebacker. There was kind of a log jam at that position. There were a lot of upperclassmen in front of me. So Coach O, after my freshman year, sat me down. He said the best opportunity for you to get on the field would be to make the transition to tight end. And I didn't question him. I just kind of picked it up and ran with it, and it's worked out so far.
Now, I've been told that offensive linemen have, you know, they want – now, with center, you touch the ball every
right.
down.
Yeah.
But most offensive linemen dream of catching a touchdown pass or catching a ball. Did something just go, oh, yeah, tied in? Did that kind of excite you a little bit?
That was the biggest thing. I mean, everything about being a tight end, I had to learn how to run routes again and how to get used to catching the ball. And it's a lot different coming from high school. Just I thought I'd be good when it came to blocking because I was used to it, but everybody's bigger in college. You got to really get down to the basics of, you know, just having a base and having your hands inside. And just I'm glad that we made the change, and I'm glad that Coach O, he didn't take it easy on me at first. I'm glad he didn't. He laid into me when I messed up, and it's really made me.
Now, have you ever been, you're in your tight end position, you look down the line, and you just think, God, he's doing that wrong. That's bad technique.
No,
come on, Nobody's watching it.
No, I never question. No,
sir. No? All right, you're a business major. What do you hope to do with that when your playing days are over?
I'm still undecided on what I want to do with that major, but I just know it's very broad, and I'm enjoying the classes that I'm in right now, so I'm sure. Once I'm out, I'll figure out what I want to do.
When you're off the field, what do you like to do? What are some hobbies?
I like hanging out with my friends, kind of just hanging out, doing whatever. I like playing basketball in my free time.
So it's game day. Let's fast forward to this Saturday when you guys host Cincinnati Christian. It's game day. And then maybe rewind back when you were a lineman. Do you prepare differently for the game? I'm not talking about practice during the week. Obviously, there's a whole different side of the practice, but getting yourself ready for the game, different type of music, different type of superstition. Is there anything different, or did it translate straight into college what you did in pregame at high school?
It's pretty much the same. I mean, I like to I listen to the same music. I have a wide variety of music I listen to before the game, but I just try to stay calm and prepare watching film throughout the week. That really helps knowing what they do. That was one of the bigger things in high school. You don't really focus on that as much, but in college you really need to watch film and watch the techniques and know why you're blocking this guy on this play. And that was really the biggest thing.
All right, so tight end position is so huge at Lindsey Wilson. A lot of people, it kind of goes unnoticed a lot of times because you have such good wideouts, such good slot players, and or slot receivers, and then some of our backs catch out of the backfield. What do you like best? Do you like running the routes, catching the football, or do you like, which is a huge part of our game, blocking up front?
I do enjoy blocking the most. I'm used to it from playing offensive line in high school. But I just want to do my job. I know if I do my job, it's easy having a guy like Rise in the backfield to block for because he's going to make a play regardless. So I just try to do my job, and I know that it'll work out.
Scotty, thanks so much for joining us. Have a great rest of the season.
Yes, sir.
Scotty Kratz, our student athlete spotlight this week. We'll step away for 1 minute. We'll come back with Coach. This is the Coach Chris Oliver Show on the Lindsey Wilson Sports Network. Welcome back to the Coach Chris Oliver Show. Coach rejoins me now, and Scotty Kratz, There's a little bit of a pressure on this tight end core because there was you graduated some really good tight ends a year ago, but I thought so far through four games that they've done an admirable job.
Yeah, they're growing up and kind of trial by fire. Mm-hmm. You know, Scotty's the guy that is getting the most reps and leading that group, and he's doing a good job for us. And you know, we're young at that position. Mm-hmm. We're not terribly experienced, like you said. We graduated two seniors with a ton of experience. And we knew that there were going to be some changes in that group. And tight end's such a big part of our offense. Yeah. And, you know, some of it you see statistically, and then there's other things you just don't see how much we ask of our tight ends. And it's a lot. But Scotty's done a great job, and he's a great young man. Came out of Cal, Christian Academy of Louisville. And, you know, he was an undersized offensive lineman in high school and played some linebacker as well. You know, probably wouldn't have played offensive line at most high schools, but they're a mid-level size high school and a good, really good program, very good program. You know, when we knew that he was either going to be a linebacker when he came in or maybe grow into a defensive end, and then, you know, as his early career developed, we thought, well, there's a future here at tight end. And, you know, we made that decision to have him at tight end, and he's blossomed there. So you don't have many guys out there catching the ball who at once played offensive line in high school not that long ago. His path is a little bit different, but he's done a great job and you know, works hard and has a very bright future.
Lindsey Wilson falls to Presbyterian 10-0. Coach, before we go through our players of the week that you guys decide on, I want to let people know out there, if you watch the game or listen to us on the broadcast, Lou Bunning was injured last minute of the game, and give us an update on Lou.
Oh, you know, he had a lower leg injury and had required surgery, and surgery went well. He's very upbeat, and, you know, he's going to make a full recovery. And, you know, he's a great young man. Mm-hmm. He's a captain for us, and, you know, we're going to miss him. And, you know, it's a shame that it ever happened. And, you know, then you look at the circumstance of, like you said, the last minute of the game, and it adds a little bit more disappointment to the whole thing. But he's a great young man, great family, and he's very upbeat, and he's ready for us to continue this journey.
All right, Coach, each week you guys, the coaching staff goes through the film and hands out some players of the week. Let's go through that list.
Yeah, you know, this week's list is a little bit shorter than some other weeks, as we know, but defensively, again, we played really well in some spots on defense. C.J. Dickerson and Trent Mueller were our co-players of the week on defense. Special teams, Jared Doherty, we felt like he punted the ball really well, had a great kickoff. Prep offense was Kobe Belcher at running back. Prep defense, Ben Kalu, Deontay Burt, and Cooper Gray. Ben is a defensive lineman, and then Deontay Burt and Cooper Gray are DBs for us, and both those guys, or all three of those guys, had great weeks. And then Deontay Burt shows up again on prep special teams, had an outstanding week for us, along with Cameron Stewart from Tate's Creek. We've called his name a few times this year as well. So it's good to see those guys continuing to get it done, continuing to practice hard, and we're looking forward to another great week of practice this week.
This week, Lindsey Wilson hosts Cincinnati Christian back home at Blue Raider Stadium. The first time we've been there in a while, and it's homecoming weekend. Coach, it's always kind of homecoming didn't mean a lot, except it was just another game for Lindsey Wilson football for probably the first 4 or 5 years. Now, in year 9, you got some guys who get to come back, who's been part of the program, and it's starting to mean even more to LWC football.
Yeah, I think it's always good anytime you can get your alumni back. And you know, now that we're actually graduating guys, you know, and it's not just about football. It's about all the other alumni and all the other folks who get an opportunity to come back to campus, not just for the football game, but there's plenty of other activities that are going on, you know, all weekend. So, you know, we want to have a big crowd and get people back. But it is fun to see guys who have been through the program, earned their degree, played football for the Blue Raiders and graduated and now coming back to games. And, you know, that's an awesome opportunity. It's fun to see that as a head coach. And we've been here 9 years now, 9 seasons, 8 and a half, you know, in the middle of season 9. To see those guys grow up and some of them are getting married and starting to have kids and those things, I mean, that's an awesome deal. Mm-hmm. And we're looking forward to seeing those guys on Saturday.
And Cincinnati Christian comes to town, first divisional game of the season. So while every game's important throughout the year, I mean, you want to be in the top 20, you want to win every time you have an opportunity, these next 6 games are – escalated a bit because they are divisional games. You want to win your division. That's probably goal number one when you start the year.
Yeah, absolutely. And we talked about that at our team meeting after the game. But we said, hey, all of our goals are still in front of us. You know, we're not going to excuse the loss, or we're not going to make excuses for it, you know, but all of our goals are still in front of us. And, you know, those goals start with winning in the MSC Bluegrass. And the only way you can do that is if you go 1-0. So this is the first challenge for us. And, you know, we're looking forward to getting back on the field this Saturday against Cincinnati Christian.
And they have a new coach, new coaching staff up there. One of the newest programs in the Mid-South Conference. There's still a couple that's added since. But have they changed schematically much?
Yeah, offensively you're seeing a change. It's clear that they're moving in the right direction. They seem to be better coached on offense than they've been. They have more of an identity than what they've had the past couple years. You know, so it's easy to see that they're improving defensively. They're still doing a lot of the same things. But, you know, this is a program that's moving in the right direction. I'm sure they're not where they want to be yet, and they're going to continue to grow up. This is a team that, you know, was with Cumberland U last week. Yeah. It was 10-10 late in the third quarter, and Cumberland U made a couple plays to pull away. One of those touchdowns was in the final minute. But, you know, that was a close game, and they gave Cumberland U a great game, and they battled. So it's a team you can see on video start to get some confidence, and you know, you go out and make a play here and there and you build confidence, and you can see that, hey, we are moving the right direction. So, you know, that's what I'm seeing with CCU. We got to make sure that, again, it doesn't matter who we're playing, we have to take care of all the things that we can control, and that's what we need to get back to doing.
Yeah, and that's this Saturday, 2:30, not 1:30, but 2:30 Central Time at Blue Raider Stadium. A little bit of an adjustment change because of homecoming. So 2:30 p.m. Central Time, we'll have the covers live here on the Lindsey Wilson Sports Network, being at 1:45 with our pregame show. That'll do this week's show. I want to thank Scotty Krantz for joining us. As always, Coach Chris Oliver. This has been the Coach Chris Oliver Show on the Lindsey Wilson Sports Network.